Hi everyone and welcome to the Spotter Fest. Being the last day of the year, let's make the most of it and let's discuss the three spotters as we had planned at 7 p.m., 9 p.m. and 11 p.m. So beginning with the first one of the day, and that happens to be a bony lesion. I've shown you the lower magnification and the higher magnification of the same. And when this is a bony lesion that we are talking about, I have to concentrate on the bony trabeculae. For those who got it right, amazing. This is a case of fibrous dysplasia. So how did I identify that this is a fibrous dysplasia? So the first and the most characteristic thing that I see out here is that the bony trabeculae are all weird shaped. They are like Chinese letter. They are curved. They are all taking weird alphabetical shapes. So I call them, either they look like a C or an S, or they look like some random Chinese alphabet. So first and foremost, I see a Chinese letter appearance. Now, when they are talking about Chinese letter, this is also, you know, they've given it many names. Some people like to call it the fish hook type of bony trabeculae because this looks like the fish hook used for catching fish. Some people also like to call it the curvilinear bony trabeculae because they are taking all types of curves that are there. So a lot of different names depending on imagination given. But when I look at the higher part, so have a look at this bony trabeculae over here. It's again a very weird shape like a Chinese letter, but if I see it's all pink, do you see any line of cells around it? You do not. This means it is not lined by osteoblasts, and that is a very important finding that you have over here. There is no osteoblastic rimming that is noted. There is no osteoblastic rimming noted in dysplasia. So please remember, first, Chinese letter pattern. Secondly, there is no osteoblastic rimming. That is fibrous dysplasia. And if someone asks you what is the genetic alteration, it is associated with GNAS mutations. Now, I'm giving you a little bit of a homework out here as well. You need to tell me two syndromes with which fibrous dysplasia can be seen. There are two syndromes and I'll give you the biggest hint. Both the syndromes start with M. They both show you this GNAS mutation and both of them show you fibrous dysplasia. So you need to comment in the comment section below and let me know so that I can also know that you guys have been studying very well. So two syndromes for fibrous dysplasia, which wraps up the first spotter for the day. Now see you again at 9 o'clock and at 11 o'clock where we are going to discuss the others.